Hi, greetings from South Korea. My name is Min Kim, and I'm chief of the Global Cooperation Section from Caris. Just to briefly mention what Caris is and what we do. Caris stands for the Korea Education and Research Information Service, and is a public institution in the field of ICT in education, working under Korean Ministry of Education. Caris conducts a wide range of research from digital literacy and teacher professional development to designing future classroom. Also, Caris is providing a number of public services, and today I'd like to mention a few that are directly related to online learning. I would like to start by mentioning South Korea's national response to COVID-19. South Korea was one of the first countries hit by COVID-19 with the first positive case in mid-January. The number reached 1,000 in a month's time period, which the government raised the national alert level to the highest category, and a national health emergency was claimed. As of today, Korea seems to be controlling the spread of the virus as the curve is in steady decline, and the number of positive cases and deaths over the past few weeks have almost flattened. However, at the same day, when the highest alert level was announced on the 23rd of February, the Minister of Education also announced to push back the opening of schools for the new school year, which was scheduled in 1st of March. This was not an easy decision to make, as it is the first time something of this nature has happened in 59 years. Given how education is so deeply valued in Korea, Korea is one of the countries who's spending the largest amount of money in education and has the highest proportion of students with tertiary degree and so on. That is why the decision to push back the start date of school shows how seriously Korea deemed the situation in February. As the virus has not been completely eradicated, there have been three more delays to open schools, and final decision was made to reopen through online learning on the 9th of April. This has left about a 5-week period where schools were not in session. As this is first time something like this has happened in Korea's recent history, trying to mitigate unknown consequences has been key. For that reason, the online implementation of classes is scheduled in a phased opening, meaning that grade 9 and 12 students in middle and high school will start first, and other grade levels will follow in the days and weeks to come. As of yesterday, April 9th, the online semester has officially begun for grade 9 and grade 12.